Hello, everybody. Scott Golden here with the Golden Opportunities Coaching YouTube channel and the Pro Wrestling Logic YouTube channel. Either way, welcome. And anyway, we've got over 2,200 of these available for your listening pleasure. We'd continue to try to bring you the best in pro wrestling, both old school and new school, in any event. This is the Wrestling Challenge Review Series for the 29th September 1991. We will go back to 1994 after this particular foray into the series. But anyway, 1991, an interesting time. Ric Flair coming into the company at a time that is, I guess you'd say, somewhat pivotal, historically speaking. Anyway, we continue into the wonder that is Sid Justice pinning Big Bully Busick with Harvey Whippleman in 37 seconds with a powerbomb. Prior to the bout, Whippleman grabbed the microphone and said that he and Busick tried to bully ring announcer Mike McGurk into saying that Busick wanted more competition, including blowing smoke in her face. Sid comes out to answer the challenge. Sid basically gets a kick and the powerbomb. 37 seconds, big way to thrust him, meaning Sid, over. They had plans on him being a big baby face, but the injury that he ends up with doesn't always allow that. Nasty Boys, former tag team champions, out next with Jimmy Hart defeating Filippalo and Bill Pierce when Sags pins Pierce after flying elbow smash at 241. Nasty Boys obviously less technical in their pursuit of things. Ultimately, punch, kick, basic maneuvers, and the power slam, top rope, elbow, smash, run there. Very basic, and continuing to get things going. And as we continue to foray into that for them, certainly things are kind of interesting situation, as it were. Anyhow, we continue to get the kind of matches going in and around the process here. And we see the Nasty Boys still trying. They are with Jimmy Hart for a couple more months. I believe they leave by early 92. But that's kind of where, they get a babyface run into 93 before leaving for World Championship Wrestling for the start of 1994. In any event, we get the next in series of matches here, which happens to be the run of, kind of getting things going. Obviously, Ric Flair, your main guy here, also lots of, lack of happiness from the from things. Again, the Undertaker and Sid Justice feud starts. They're bringing that to Boston. Pretty major deal there. Sid promises to avenge Randy Savage from the attack of Jake Roberts and the Undertaker, and this is the September 29th edition of the house shows. Boston Garden tonight is where they're going to be. Then we move to another in the enhancement series. Ricky Steamboat out next, breathing fire. Ricky Steamboat, of course, the Dragon, former Intercontinental Champion, and manages to go toe-to-toe with his adversary in this particular contest, which happens to also be none other than Mike Williams, flying body press 225. They brawl to the outside. Steamboat hits a couple of chops and other basic maneuvers along the way. Steamboat slides through the legs, hits a couple of shots, and manages to get things going his way. Flying body press, 1, 2, 3, away we go here, and ultimately manages to do what he can where he can. Steamboat 1991, actually Steamboat's second run here in the WWF, really feels kind of like a punishment run. The only notable thing he does is the breathing of the fire. Nasty Boys want the tag team championships back from the Legion of Doom. Ted DiBiase wants to get even with Virgil for defeating him at SummerSlam. The bowl ring deal with Tito Santana, El Matador, is here. Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase out with Sensational Sherry. Million Dollar Man faces off against Enhancement Talent, who happens to be a guy by the name of Mark Thomas. Meets him with a submission, Million Dollar Dream, Power Slam, punches, kicks, and the Million Dollar Dream in 1 minute 56 seconds. DiBiase is in complete control the entire duration of the match, so it's easy to see that they have a plan for him, certainly. Then we go into another in the match series, and that happens to be IRS pinning Ray Garcia right off 226, hits the Samoan drop after a couple of abdominal stretches, punches, kicks, and basic maneuvers. IRS doesn't really have a major feud yet. Ric Flair wins with the figure four over Jim Powers in 1 minute 26 seconds. May actually be Flair's first official, I think definitely his first challenge match. Also, the new tag team champions, the LOD, are on the barber shop here. LOD promised to get rid of both the Nasty Boys and the Natural Disasters, Jimmy Hart managing two tag teams at the same time during this particular foray into things, which ends up causing problems down the road. IRS managing to be happy with his win, and ultimately there we go. Anyway, regardless, we have a run, Ric Flair getting the victory there, and we will close with this. We'll be back with more right after this.